Hi guys, it's me Paul again, and today I'm going to show you how to clean your bubble tubes out. So as you can see, I've got a bubble tube here that somebody gave me. So I know this is being used by normal water because I can see all of the bubbles on the skin of the tube from the inside. So what I'm going to do is put some water in it by using a jug, and then when it gets lily at the top, I'll put some washing up liquid in it, just to make sure the motor's not clogged up, but I know it works. So first of all, what I want to do, just take the lid off. I've got the fish as well, so I know they are working. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to put some fresh water in. Right, so what I'm going to do is I'll pour some water in it. You have to do this a couple of times just to make sure it works. So I'm just going to use normal water for this experiment. This is a good way to check if it's leaking as well, but I know this isn't. So you just want to keep filling it up. So basically, if you just do it in the bathroom instead of anywhere else. So I'm just using cold water in here. But with these bubble tubes, you must use ionised water because it will keep the pump working. But if you use normal water like I'm doing here, it will go like a fish tank, and you don't want that because you have to get one of those tube brushes or toilet brush, and then you have to put your hand in and get all the debris out. Plus the motor will suffer as well. Be very careful with these. Just fill this up. Plus, you don't want to knock it over either, so you just got to be so careful with it. And when you get near to the top, all you have to do is put a few drops of washing up liquid. I won't fill it right up to the top. Okay. Now I want to keep the lid on the top. Okay, now I'm going to move it to a plug socket and then we'll plug it back in. So I'll be back in a second, guys. So there we go, guys. So I've just put it there. Now I'm going to turn it on and then drop in some washing up liquid. So we know this works. There we go. Turn the light off. There we go. So we know it works. Lights still work. That's a nice blue. Yeah, that's okay. So make sure the lights work as well, as you can see. I know it's very hard to see. And then just leave that to set for a few minutes. And then all you want to do it's going. Just put a few drops of washing up liquid in. And then when that's in there, just grab your fish and then just put them in. As you can see, it's foaming at the top.
So then I'm going to move the camera there.
Let's turn that off.
So then you can actually see it. You leave that on for a few minutes, like that.
And what you're looking for is any debris inside the tubing.
So any black spots.
So you're just looking at that. And as you can see, the foam is already started at the top. And that's all you need to do. Now I've just got to turn it off. As you can see, it's foaming at the top.
So when it starts foaming at top,
so there we go, and then all you got to do is then empty it. So I'll do that now. So just turn it off and then leave the fish to go down. So that's a good indication that the pump is working. So that's the washing up liquid, that's actually done its job. And then you just empty it and you know that's been cleaned. So let that float down. Sometimes you get the odd fish at the top. That looks all done. So I'll be in the bathroom now emptying this. Back in a minute, guys.
So then, guys, to empty it, you just grab your bubble tube and you just slowly tilt it. And then you just undo it. And then you just pour it out like this. There we go. And make sure the water is nice and clear inside as well. There we go. And that's freshly washed. So all you got to do now is put some more water in that and just empty all the washing up liquid. So yeah. So it should then look like that. If there's any black bits or any debris, you'll see it. So it means you have to do this a few times. Let's have a look inside the bubble tube. Don't know if you can see that. That doesn't look too bad. So yeah, that's all you gotta do, guys. Now I'm gonna refill this and then get the rest of it out. Back in a minute. So there we go, guys. I've just refilled it with fresh water. Now I just gotta plug it in and circulate the pump. So back in a second. So there we go, guys. Just gonna turn it on. There we go. And that's all you gotta do. And then as the fresh water is now in it, so like I said, you just gotta check for debris. So anything black or anything that shouldn't be in there. So yeah, there we go. And then you can just take the top off and you can just check in there. So yeah, that's all you gotta do. There we go. I won't put the fish back in it because you really want to check the debris. So if I turn this off, turn that off. There we go. You just want to check any debris at all.
very difficult to see when it's on the blue colour. And there we go, you've changed the water, you've cleaned it, and that's all you got to do. Okay. I know it's difficult to see, but there's all the foam that we did in the first bit. You can hear it as well. So yeah, so that's how you clean a bubble tube out. Now if it does go green with the water that I've got in here, so say you left it in there for a couple of months, you will have to do it like a fish tank. So you have to get the water out and then rinse it out and then use a toilet brush, a clean one, and just spin it inside. And that's how you look after a bubble tube. But remember guys, ionized water. That's what you'll have to use. Put the camera back there. And that's it. There you go. Here's the cake, guys. And that's how you clean the inside of a bubble tube. So ionized water. And it will last for years. So yeah. That's all you got to do, guys. So yeah, just to clean it out, put fresh water in, and make sure this pump works, which it is. A dash of washing up liquid. Make sure it gets to the bottom, to the top. And then, hey presto, it's fine. So yeah. And yeah, you just want to keep it on for a little while, make sure it circulates from the bottom to the top. And then, that's all you got to do, guys, to make sure that your bubble tubes are still working. So ionized water in these will last a lot longer. If you use normal water, you just have to keep tipping it out every few times. And if the tube itself goes dark green like a fish tank, you have to empty the water out, put some fresh water in, a bit of washing up liquid, and one of those toilet brushes from the top, or you can have it on its side. And then you just got to gently twist and get all the debris out the tube. But I've just done it quickly with fresh water, a bit of washing up liquid. I recommend Fairy or anything else. If you get any cheaper options, that'll be fine, but just not too much, just a little bit. And that's how I clean the bubble tubes out with fresh water. And I've got the fish here, so they're all right as well. So yeah. And that's about it, guys. That's how you clean a bubble tube out after you using it with fresh water or water that's been in it for a bit of time. So yeah, so any questions, guys, just let me know in the comments. Tell me what you think. And yeah, if you've got a sensory room, let me know if you've got one of these, because I've got one of these in my room and it's been running for about 5 years. 6 years now. So yeah, that's all you gotta do. Yeah, so yeah, like I said, subscribe, like, comment, whatever you want to do, guys. I'd love to hear what your bubble tubes are like, what you've done to clean them. So if you've got any tips to clean them, I'd love to know so I can try some out. So yeah. Right then, guys, I'm going to love you and leave you, and I'll be back soon for another sensory video or inflatables, whatever I've got, because it's cold weather, so might as well do so. Let's turn this off. So yeah, I'm going to empty this, so I'll see you guys soon for another video. So enjoy your weekend, guys. Bye for now.